Now, by all means, you should use the library functions like random.shuffle. That's what they're there for. But I'm going to allow a little bit of a diversion here because the shuffle algorithm is one that's important to me personally. It was the first non-trivial algorithm that I came up with on my own when I was in high school, and one of the first cases where I saw that my teacher was just completely wrong. Now, here's the algorithm that my teacher was trying to describe to me. And, of course, I went to high school in the dark ages before there was any Python, so it wasn't written in exactly this language, but I've translated into Python to make sense to you. Here's what the algorithm does. It says, we're going to keep track with an array of which items have been swapped so far, and then until they've all been swapped at least once, we're going to generate two random indices into that array, and then swap them and record the fact that they were both swapped, and keep going until all the items have been swapped at least once. So it looks like this. Again, we have this deck of cards, and then we have a parallel array of the same length, which tells us whether we've been swapped or not, and that starts out as being all false, while this one starts out being cards. And then we go through and we pick out random numbers. So say we pick out I and J as being here and here, and say we have a nine of diamonds there, then we're going to just swap the two. And so we cross those out. We now have seven of spades there and the nine of diamonds there. And we mark the two spots as being swapped. So now this one's true and this one's true. Those two spots have been swapped, and then we keep on going until all the elements of swapped are all equal to true, then we know we're done. So that's what my teacher was trying to sell to me that day in high school, and I was sitting in the back, and I just woke up, and I said, that can't be right. I just had this visceral reaction that said, I can see what the algorithm does, and I know it swaps everything, but it just seems too inefficient. It has this loop that keeps on going, and it's not a for loop. It's a while loop, and it just seemed to me that it was possible that this loop could go forever. Depending on the choice of random numbers, this might never terminate, and that just seemed wrong. It seemed like there was a much better way, and in my head, I came up with the shuffle algorithm that we showed before. Knuth calls it algorithm P for permutation. It just seemed like that was a simple and correct way, and this was just too complicated, and that really bothered me. I thought that an algorithm should be guaranteed to terminate.